So let's see. There's three guys left.
You'd have more chances at D&D, though.
This little guy's gonna try to get to you over the corpses of his friends.
So he needs a dex check?
He's gotta do a dex check. This guy's gonna attack you, Daniel, and this one is turning to attack you.
Yay!
So I potentially have two attacks.
First, me. Let's see how the one similar in weight die.
They're pretty small. He makes it, so they're gonna have two on you, Daniel. And then let's go ahead and we'll do yours first. I'm class 5.
I'm at 3.
Okay, he misses you. Swish.
Me and them are at the same time.
Right, I'm just rolling the damage first. If you say you get knocked out this time, you still get to do all your shit before it happens. You're just fighting, right? You're just going to try to kill him.
So if I killed him, then does it negate the damage that I took?
No.
It's simultaneous. You're swinging. You always fall swing at the same time.
So, like, you could...
Natural 20.
Oh, God.
Yay!
The excitement of natural 20.
You have the worst luck.
I'll do piercing, 23. It'll do double damage. We'll just keep double. 2 points of damage, because I rolled a 1 for damage. And the other guy, it is. I'm a class 16. All right, Daniel.
I'm still alive.
You still have points.
One.
There's 1 hit point left. Okay, so roll to hit this guy that just stabbed you. Oh no, you should even come.
6.
Armor class 6 is a hit. Roll me damage.
D4?
D8 plus 3 because of your strength bonus. You guys are the heavy hitter in the group.
I wasn't though.
God, 4.
4 points, down it goes. They're kobolds, they don't take much damage. Probably the one that didn't climb over the body.
Yeah, that one.
Either one, doesn't matter.
First,
the one that just stabbed you. Has anybody. We got people that still have guns around. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Is everybody gone?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right.
Throw rocks or something.
God damn it.
Drop.
Okay.
Start rolling.
Everybody ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They're going in 7 too.
Oh, God.
We have one on you now, Daniel. And we've got one trying to fight you. We're going to go for you first. Armor class 10 is a miss. And Daniel, so is yours. Armor class 13 is a miss. Roll to hit.
1.
Natural 1.
No, 20 minus 19.
Oh, yeah, that's it. I got people doing all kinds of stuff, so roll me damage.
Yeah, some people are doing the math.
Yes, do the damn math. All I do is get AC.
Good man.
Yeah, down he
like
goes.
Like I said, if I'm a physics major, why would I take that major?
Because math is part of physics. 8, 9, 10.
Okay, so I'm gonna tell the kobold surrender or die. The last remaining kobold.
Oh, you're right. I keep forgetting your morale checks. Let's check his morale. What's his morale? Very bad.
Probably in a room.
Nope, he's like, hey, you are awful evil monsters who come to kill our children, I need a young
That was only one time.
I heard about this crazy lady across the way.
She's awesome.
All right. So yeah, you yell from surrender, he
refused. I've heard of a level 1 character that died in a game.
No. No, I rolled a 5, and his morale is 7, so. 11. 12.
Yeah.
What you doing? There's one goblin left.
One goblin left. Can I? No, I probably shouldn't try to rest. I'm just gonna stab.
You could try to knock him out.
Yeah, you
try
should.
To burn the hole.
That would require all the grapple hooks.
Capture him.
All right. Actually, yeah, I have.
Hitting the flat of the blade.
Keep
is like.
I have a buzzword.
Hitting with the flat of the blade is like a negative 4 to hit. And then if you do succeed in hitting his arm class, the damage is temporary, so you won't kill him, you're just like knocking him out. So you still have to roll your damage, and then if it's enough to put him at 0 or less, then he's just out of combat. And you can bundle him up and run away with him, or however you want to go and take.
I don't think they happen to have any information.
It's up to you. He's trying to talk to him, and then you shield something about get one to question.
Alright, I will do. I'll do that.
You cooperating? Oh my god. Awesome.
He might tell us about treasure.
Hey, at least he's not here. He'd be like, drink his blood, stop it.
I rolled
5. Okay, you try to pop him in the head, and it doesn't work. Has everybody gone this round yet?
Nope.
Okay, 13, 14. Well, Katelyn, you're the only one left, so what do you want to do? She just yelled, running a prisoner, and you can't do incapacitating damage with arrows, unfortunately.
Yeah.
You get,
get arrows.
Can from here?
They make them.
If you want to drop your bow, you can draw your sword, and you can hit him with the flat of your bow. It's -4 to hit. But if you hit him, the damage is temporary, and you can't kill him that way. You'll just knock him out. Okay. Cooperation with the party. Oh my god. Okay, so you drop your bow at your feet, you draw your short sword, and you try to whack him in the head with it.
Yeah.
So it's -4 to hit. So roll your d20, and then you add 1 for your sword. No, you don't. Roll d20, subtract 4, and subtract it from 10.
So
-4 is a 15. And 20 minus 15 is on plus 5 is a hit. So roll me damage.
Wow, nicely done.
So you just lean around the corner. See if it knocks him out. Roll damage. It's regular damage. I think it's a d6 for a short sword. 4, yeah. Bam! And he's like, and just drops to the ground out cold. There's a little bit of blood, but she didn't hit him to kill. She just gave him a little whack. Down he goes. Good job.
She can retrieve the rope and tie him up if she wants.
Okay, you say that.
Keep it tied to the tree.
Okay, here's the thing. You guys have kind of an idea where the trap is, thanks to Mike.
Yeah.
If you want to get across it, going through the corners, as long as someone helps you, you can automatically help each other move from side to side.
Okay, I think this guy that buys collars, he has one, and just
Yeah, he's wearing some kind of cheapy armor. You could grab him by the armor and you can just drag him across. Yeah, he's really light.
I take him outside of the tree and then the rope's already tied around and tie him around the tree.
Okay, that's what Bran just suggested.
I searched all the kobolds.
Oh yeah, you're over there. Okay, so he's starting to search kobolds.
I'm right there next to the corpses.
While we're dying,
they'll die.
I'm next to the corpses.
Unless your friend's fine. You gonna murder these guys too?
Maybe later.
I'm next to the corpses too,
you're
so I search them too.
Okay, how many's over? Is it 5 again? God damn it. Okay, each of you roll d20. Whoever rolls highest can search the most at first.
I'm just gonna
I rolled a 12.
Okay, so you get 3 and you get 2. Let's see. How about the bad flash? No. Oh, okay. And you need to write yours down. Okay, so 3.
Just
to get this. So, Daniel, you get 10 silver pieces.
That's it?
Yeah, they're just carrying silver coins on them. 3 silver coins each. They have daggers. Oh, shoot. Screw that. Oh, well, too bad. They're daggers. You might be able to get a couple of copper pieces for them if you want. You guys have taken the other kobold outside. Did you help her? Did you help Ashton across the pit?
I was going to start first.
Okay,
tie him up first.
So you tie him up, you can come back and help Ashton across the pit.
Yep.
And then about
I
that
start
time
throwing
you
bodies down.
Oh, yeah, you just toss them down.
Do I need to make a strength check?
Crack. Snap.
Huh? Do I need to make a strength check again?
No. Okay. If you guys are just working together, no.
Ooh, how do you like your home now, guys?
And you guys are alone.
I'm about to come out and join y'all.
I don't know.
You can jump over the hole
again. No,
these are really good. Okay, one of them you drop this nasty crap noise. I think he's pretty much probably dead. Did somebody help the two of you guys across?
No.
Oh, are you going to? No, you don't have to. You guys walk out hand in hand.
You're on the other side too.
They're busy looting. I don't care.
No, we're done looting.
If Daniel helps you across first, since you're smaller, then you can help him across.
Still
we'll do that.
You're badly hurt too, so he's all covered in blood. He's all
I'm gonna suggest going back to town.
All these little stab wounds on him and shit.
I got
you don't have a cleric anymore.
I've got him.
Okay, so
because this guy's probably still out.
What now?
Wait, now
he's gonna
come too.
Oh, yeah. You can slap his face a few times, bring him around if you want once he's tied up. Okay, so you wake him up. He's he starts speaking in kobold.
I can't understand, so
I'm like, shit. He seems really defiant.
Yeah. All
so.
Right. Do I need to do anything?
He's telling you to let him go or feel the wrath of his people. They will swarm over you like the wolves swarm over a bear, that kind of shit. You know, he's real mouthy.
I take out one of my arrows. I grab his hand and I'm like, should I?
I mean, we can kill you right now, or you can tell us what else is in that cave.
You will kill me anyway. I know that. You're coming to kill my family and my children. You terrible people.
You can die now. Well,
do you have a charm person spell?
Yes, but I have to come back.
Okay.
Or we could take him to town and then do it later.
So I.
She hasn't given you an answer yet.
Can I?
Talk about them.
Well, are you? I'm gonna like come up and start like peeling scales off.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
God, no, stop.
Oh, that
one of the top,
I knew it.
Right?
I knew it.
I love how good. It.
No, that's not what you would say. What would you say?
No, I know, but.
No, stop.
No, I'm going to tell him stop. Like, yeah. Let's just take him back to town and get rest. I mean, he's badly injured.
You want information out of him or not?
I do, but I can get it.
Bleeding over here.
He looks
bleeding out.
You know what we could use? A fucking cleric.
Well, I kind of lost him. Go ahead. I just shut him in the room.
Yeah, well.
Oh, her. Okay, so you guys go back to the keep then?
Mm-hmm.
All right. You go back to the keep. You've got your prisoner. Your question about why you want to bring a kobold into the keep.
He has information that we want.
All right, if he gets loose, you're going to be in big trouble, is what you're told. You will probably be expelled from the keep and not be allowed to return. He is your responsibility.
I could cut his legs off.
Don't, yeah.
He's tied up.
Yeah, no, they wait, see. No, you got 50 sorry. Feet of rope you've tied him up.
He's just like
he's
wrapped
real,
up with
he's tied up like
rope.
Mad Martha would. Okay. So yeah, they'll let you bring him in, but if he gets out and like hurts people, or if anybody gets killed, you're gonna be
responsible. He doesn't have any weapons either. It'd be pretty hard for him to.
Okay, so he goes to the keep. He's all tied up. I'm gonna give him a 1% chance of being able to like break away, just like I gave Matt and Martha. No, there's almost no chance he would get away. So you guys, where do you want to spend the night?
yeah,
you guys might have to spend a couple days resting to get you healed up. But since no cleric.
Take me to the chapel. Okay,
rogue, cheese, DMW,
throw it into your backpack.
What time is it? Like.
In real life?
No.
Oh, it's still like noon. Right, it's like noonish or so.
Oh, the morning.
You guys just
I
say
go,
you,
I go to
we're
the,
just gonna rest.
I go to the trader and sell my spearheads.
Oh, spearheads.
Yeah, she's at 2 hit points left, so she.
Are you?
Two.
You're pretty messed up too, woman. It's a shame your cleric turned into a freaking psycho.
Yeah, that was kind of.
He likes to play it fast.
Sure, it's just a few copper.
It's a crappy short sword. You can get 2 gold for it. And the spearheads, you get a silver each for them. That's what people want to pay. Okay, so are you guys going to get a room at the inn again? Or sleep in the common room tonight?
The problem is I'm not getting a loot or
yeah,
my funds
are dwindling.
Your funds are quickly dwindling. Yes.
I'm getting like a solo room.
You're getting your own room for gold piece. Ting. Okay.
I'm gonna do the common
room. Somebody wants to take a gold.
You're doing the common room again for silver. What do you? What was that?
I need my gold.
You need a gold. You want a private room? How about? Do you have any money, Ashton?
I mean, I do. I will because I have the prisoner.
Okay.
Okay. Hey everybody, this is my buddy Bob. Don't worry about Bob.
So if you want to just eat gruel that day, you can get, it's only a couple copper pieces for 2 more meals. You learn the next day on day 3 that a hobgoblin apparently came to the keep and demanded 100 gold coins for the return of a human prisoner, a woman, who was an insane priestess apparently.
We don't know who you're talking about.
Yeah, you guys can think, wow.
Yeah, damn, she is.
Let's see, what should we roll to see if the castle will actually pay it just to get back on the main? Low is going to be good. I'll roll a d20, and then you guys can help me decide. 14. Signs point to no. The castellan puts the word out in the keep. If anyone wishes to pay for this person's ransom, they can.
Even
otherwise,
if we could.
You just don't have the funds. 100 gold pieces.
I mean, I could throw a couple silver into that.
I've got a copper.
No. He's not taking up. He's just saying if anybody, he mentions her, they have given her name as Mad Martha. You recognize the name. The castellan's also willing to front the money if she has friends here. But otherwise, he doesn't know who she is, and so
she doesn't have any of those.
So there you go. You guys have the opportunity to come forward to get her rescued. It is a lot of money. Maybe you can rescue her sometime in between.
Well, my vote is.
So just because you're lawful good doesn't mean you have to do this, okay?
And if we
you want to do it. But
did I have to pay 2 gold for the night for the stay at Solarin?
No, it's just 1 gold piece per night for.
We've only been there a night. Okay.
For your own. Everybody gets a hit point back for sleeping for a night. If you spend all day convalescing, next day, you want to cast your Charm Person spell on this Kovac? Okay, I think he gets a saving throw, doesn't he?
I don't know.
Can I go to the priest and try to get healed more?
Do you have money? Because you're not from the town, so he's a little.
Can I go to the priest and take the gold?
He doesn't really.
You want to cover me since I'm your buddy?
I don't know if I have enough gold.
Bullshit. I'll go one person who knows
the person receives a saving throw versus spell to avoid the fact that he
okay.
If you want to keep my mouth shut, it's going to help me.
I mean, I've got a couple.
Saving throws, no. Saving throws, they're here. Warriors. This would be like a zero level versus spell. Holy shit. Okay, so.
Yes, Alan.
Ashton.
Yes.
If you're like, if you try to be nice to him and stuff beforehand.
Yeah.
It's helpful if he's coming at it from a position of hostility. Oh, let me do a morale check first. He still made it. He's still defiant. So that won't help you any. But how are you going to treat him before you cast the spell?
I'll buy him food.
Oh, okay, so you buy like some gruel or something and feed him some of it. He's all like, your food is terrible. I hate it.
Just so you know, he gave me 90 silver to help
nine.
Pay for
nine silver.
So I'm going to give him some of my wine I have. Like,
oh, he'll drink the wine. This wine is terrible. Give me some more. Okay, do you want to give him a lot of the wine that you have, or just a little bit?
Half my wine's gone.
Good God. Okay.
Let's give him more.
By the time you're done, he's all like, I hate you, bitches. You suck. There's things. I don't know.
So
there's a thing. All right. Yeah, he didn't make a save at all.
Yeah.
Except for you. You're my best friend. How long does that spell last? All right, let's check their intelligence.
It might not be as bad as you think.
Kidding, the footballs are clever.
It says duration's special.
Yeah, it'll be written up down below. Spell. Football.
Like I said, there is such
intelligence is average, so 8 to 10.
There was such thing as a football bar.
8 to 10?
Yeah.
Well, it's 1 month for
7 to 9,
and it's 3 weeks from 10 to
12. 8 to 10, 8, 9, 10. He has 10, so 3 weeks?
Yep.
Okay. This is second ed, right? Spells last a while. Okay, you know he's under your thrall for at least a while. You could recast the spell like every week and probably be fine if you want to keep this guy on. He's a hero, very best friend. Oh my God, I'm so glad you found me. He's all drunk and crying and shit. Anyway, so you're pretty convinced the spell worked, and you know you've got him for at least a while. When he sobers up, later that day, if those of you who are in town want to just convalesce all day, just relax, that'll give you more hit points.
Priest.
Oh, you want to go to the priest?
Priest.
Okay. He gives you the same deal.
Can I do anything possibly to persuade him lower, like any kind of check?
He didn't ever say, he just said a donation.
Yeah, he said donation.
I just got the
donation. She basically held up a gold piece. Like,
so yeah, you set
really obviously.
Yeah.
You set up a precedent.
Whatever.
She set a precedent.
Her character is also a female and attractive, so he's probably a little bit more, like, ready to do
I'll throw a gold in there.
You put a gold piece very obviously.
You made me?
You're female, though, and this guy's old, so it's like, alright, he'll cast a spell on you because you desperately need it for 5 back.
Heal you with 5 points back. With my special bomb.
But he's watching the box real closely when you put the coin in. He checks it when you leave.
Like, hey, I didn't do anything.
You tell him half that happened to stay out of here. You see him.
Ha, he didn't believe me.
Well, I didn't.
I was
you never saw him, did he?
I was talking
he didn't
to
see
him.
He was the only one in the freaking place after the money got put in that was out of his sight.
And she looked immediately. Looks
he talked the whole time.
He doesn't halfling's know that he's associating with him, though.
Yeah,
oh, that's true. If you see a halfling around here, you tell him to stay out of my, out of this chapel. He's not welcome there. All right, so you have a best friend who's a kobold. Do you guys want to do anything the rest of that day?
Come
on. Or wait another day before you do anything? And how much longer do you guys want to play? It's 5? Oh, yeah, experience points.
I mean, I can go.
No, you're done.
I want to do one more thing that day.
There's no plug?
We keep going. Don't see a stopping point, really.
Well, yeah, I want to do one more thing.
Well, you can. We can wrap it up. We can wrap it up.
Well, my friend is going to stay at the
end. Okay.
So, I'm going to go to the chapel.
Okay.
And I'm going to keep an eye out and see if the priest kind of isn't paying attention for a while.
No, he sees you come in. He's like, get out of here!
No, I'm hiding.
Make me a hide check. Or make me a sneak check, see if you can do it without the
sneak. How about hiding shadows?
Actually, if we enter early, we can...
It'd be a sneak to get in, because you're moving. Hiding in shadows is you go and then you stop. And
I gotcha.
So to get in, it'll be
real fast. So what's sneak?
Sorry, you're going to another game? Going to another game?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. 35.
Well, I am. I'm going to
pass. Hey, get out of here! You're not welcome in here, you old thief. Get! He gets a broom.
I don't know what you're talking about.
He starts hitting with it. Get out of my church! Get out of the church!
It's D&D.
You're not welcome here.
Roll this shit.
Are you going to attack? Get out! All right, keep get you out. Okay, so
they were like, "For this crap, we're going to make our
own system." Okay, so. You guys don't go back. You decide not to go back to the case for a while. You can get information on his area. You're his best friend now. You trust you can untie him and he'll be your buddy.
Is it like just because of the spell or is it because you trust him?
You don't know. You'd have to ask. Are you going to walk around the keep of this kobold without a leash or anything now? You trust him. You know this spell took effect. You know that.
Yeah.
Okay.
That just seems cool.
People look at you like. Nobody says anything. You guys notice this too. She comes to dinner that night. She's got a kobold. He's like, girl. I love this girl that you get me.
I walk in muttering about untrusted priests.
Hey, there's that halfling. Can I kill him? Dang it. Hey, there's that elf. Can I kill him? Dang it.
I've heard lizard tastes pretty good.
That guy smells good. Can I kill him? He stinks. You guys know he smells good.
Oh, have you ever eaten lizard?
Oh, quite.
It tastes pretty good.
So do hobbit feet. They're delish.
I don't know. Right? I don't know.
Oh, shit.
Oh, that roleplay is gone.
No, it's still there.
No, yeah.
I don't understand what he's saying. He just jabbed on.
I'm kicking him in the eye because I'm like, why is he just
here? He seems content. Do you buy him some gruel for a copper piece? Yeah, he's like, oh, boy. You have the best gruel. You're awesome. That's what charm person does. It makes you best friends with somebody.
How long does that last?
3 weeks.
That's what she tells me.
Oh, yeah.
I want a kobold.
I start thinking about start wondering.
You could try to start teaching him common too.
I think that would be a bad idea.
What you can learn, basically, before we go, is that, hey. You can get the layout of the kobold lair. There's a bunch of giant rats in this one room. They're in the garbage. They're really dangerous. The kobolds kind of avoid it. There's a food storage room. There's a guard room. And then there's a chieftain's room. The chieftain has a key to the storage room. And he's got a really big gem on a golden chain around his neck. It's got to be worth a bunch of money. He's got 5 females in his room.
That's not like I brought my character sheet from right again.
And then there's 17 more kobolds.
And whoever's that person.
Yeah. In the tribe. And you learn that too.
Okay.
And there's some females. And there's 23 females. 8 young. There you go. That's what you learned.
I think five corners don't meet.
So you learn that information from the cobalt, and you have them if you ever want.
There's more traps.
No, that's our only trap. It's a good one. I think they'll probably repair it pretty quick. It's probably fixed by now. So as long as you don't remember it, and fall in, don't tell your friends about it. Maybe they'll forget.
I heard about the time sheep went around.
Well, you're non-friends. Your associates. Your other people's.
Other people's.
Okay. You guys killed six more kobolds, right?
Yeah, and I used some of my slaves.
Can I just join for 20 minutes on that character?
I think Caitlin's ready to wrap up. So, I'm sorry.
I think I win this game.
Like, will we ever pick this one back up?
Probably not. It's a one shot. Yeah. Well, this is a very generic-y. Go to the caves, kill monsters, take their stuff. Other scenarios would be different. You could be actually.
Yeah,
let's see. You ran away from the. Did you kill? Oh, you. See what?
But we
could have
got a quest to do something.
He sort of did.
This is a kind of generic-y scenario, which is why I ran. To kind of give you a taste of combat and to give you kind of an idea of what the enemy can be like.
I still think we should run after the ogre.
At least we have to kill her.
Fuck it, let's go.
Do you want to go kill the ogre?
Yeah, let's try it.
You just sent away your paladin.
Oh, I don't know.
Who's going to play a paladin?
We don't need to go. I'll solo it.
What's the plan? Do you guys want to continue and try to kill the ogre, or do you want to
quit? Well, if we end early, I would have time to roll some new character.
I mean, I need to make a backup one.
I only have so many character sheets. I did not bring a whole lot. I brought some. Sounds like one. Okay, let's do that. Let me give you XP. Let me give you guys XP. What the hell? I don't think anyone's going to make any stuff.
I could, in theory.
How many? You killed six more goblins, didn't you?
No, five.
Yeah, we didn't kill the last one.
Sixth one's our buddy.
Those are kobolds.
No.
There were, weren't there? There were six goblins in that room when you lost. What's her crazy face?
And then we killed five goblins.
Okay. Goblins are again 15 each. There were six. She doesn't get XP because, well, yeah, she was part of that battle. So 15 times 6 is what? 90 divided by 5 is. No. 90 divided by 5 is like 18 XP each for them. So each get 18 experience points for that. Oh, plus, let's see, let me see the kobolds. Normally I'd write all this stuff down so I have all the math done.
I have
that
pen, so I thought I did.
Kobolds. Kobolds are worth 7 each, and there were 6 of them total. You get points for the ones that you got. So 6 times 7 is 42 divided by 4 is roughly 10 points each.
Yeah,
depends on
the 4
underneath
the
idea.
Oh, yeah.
That's probably
it.
Yep.
Okay. Bam.
And I got the 10%.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so divide that, multiply that by 10% to give yourself those points as well. Yeah, 18, no.
Yeah.
It was 18 plus 10, so 28 total so far from this day. XP.
There's like no way
I'm going to.
We need to get 2,000. I'm at 116.
The problem is I'd run out of gold before long.
Yes, that's that. You guys, it's expensive to live in the cave.
And that's what
we're looking
at? 66. Well, I was only doing, if we were there another night, I was going to switch to the common area. I was going to go up my room.
Plus, you lost your cleric, which means healing takes a lot longer. Okay, for hit dice, creature defeated fighters is going to be an extra 10 XP. Each of the fighters will get another 120 XP. So that's you too, Caitlin. You're a warrior class. Wizard, you're going to get. You cast two spells to overcome problems, right? So you get another 100. Priest is gone. And the rogue, how much?
I used Find Root Traps, and I think I used Lose Silent twice. I don't remember if we
I don't think you used it twice.
Because we didn't make you, I didn't make you roll to go in the goblin lair. You only used it, and you failed when you used it on the curate. So, fine remove trap. So 200 XP for that. And I got the wizard. And that's everything.
So that's 6.
So when you get enough experience points, you then go up a level, which gives you more hit points. Potential, your attack could change. For fighters, it goes down.
So I got that halfway.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait. Questions, comments, suggestions. Did you guys have fun? Was this interesting? Is it something that you would like to play again?
So I ended up with 10 gold, 30 silver.
Who else is broke and you got all the cash?
I got 11 gold.
That's basically 13.
I had 14 to start.
Okay. So yeah, good time, something you'd like to try again. What? What's the deal?
How much gold does everyone have?
Just a little bit.
Like nothing?
I have the basically 13.
Thanks for watching.
That's like nothing.
Oh, yeah.
Why does everyone have like hardly any gold?
I care.